Hello and welcome to the MIGRO YouTube channel. Today we're going to look at the question, what is the best spectrum for a grow light? Given all the different technologies available, be it the red, blue LEDs, high pressure sodium, full spectrum LED, and then the very confusing wide range of spectrum that can be selected from each of those technologies. And then on top of that, you have the providers of all these different spectrum telling you that theirs is the best, and for various different reasons, their spectrum has some properties which will give you a much better yield than another spectrum. And all the while, it's very confusing because you can't really compare these things directly. There doesn't seem to be any overview as to what these spectrum really are made up of, and what are the differences in our trade-offs between one and the other. So we'll try and describe here and explain, first of all, what's in these different grow light spectrum, what makes them different, and then what growth characteristics you can expect from your plants when grown under these different grow light spectrum. And we're not going to use our own opinion in generating this information and providing it to you. We're going to use a comprehensive recent study on the effects of different grow light spectrum on plants, and it was done by scientists in Utah State University just last year. And we are going to show you, going to extract the critical information from this study and share it with you in hopefully as straightforward and simple a way as possible to understand. So in this study, they used 8 different grow light spectrum, and just going to show them here what their makeup is in blue, green and red, which are the constituent colors of all light. You can see that they used 3 fairly extreme examples, which are almost pure blue, green and red. They're not generally used or widely available as a light source, but they've used them here for demonstration purposes for this experiment, and so we're going to see what the extremes will produce in plant growth. The 5 spectrum in the middle, however, are widely available and the most commonly used grow light spectrum for grow lights, and it starts off with the on the left hand side the warmer or lower color temperature light mixes. So, you know, typically this would be down at the HPS spectrum, where you'd be getting a warm orange light, and the color temperature would be around 2,000 to 3,000 Kelvin. And then as you go along to the right, you're getting an increase in the amount of blue in the light spectrum, and this turns the overall color from being more orangey to more blue, and you get the cooler, higher color temperature spectrum when you have more blue mixed in with the red and the green. For each of these spectrum then, in this experiment, 7 plant species were tested. They were tested under different levels of light, but most importantly, they were tested for different growth characteristics. Some of the growth characteristics, such as chlorophyll concentration, pietal length, leaf area, we're not going to look at here because they're not critical to us. We're going to look at the ones which are most important as indoor growers, which is the yield in mass and the density of the growth, which would be defined by the stem length or the distance between nodes. So we're looking at dry mass yield first, and you can see that the red-blue LED spectrum performed the highest. It just pipped the other mixed spectrum by a small amount, but it was definitely the highest. So we have that and the mid-temperature, sort of 3,500 K spectrum, very similar to the MIGRO spectrum, are within 5% of each other and fairly clear at the top. Very interestingly, the red and the green and the blue, where it does not a large mixing of the spectrum, they perform at a lower level. So it does prove that you're better to have a mixed spectrum rather than a pure spectrum in any particular of any particular color. Next thing is you can see that the green and the red are very closely matched, so they are as within 5% of photosynthetic efficiency, and the blue is significantly less than the red and the green. But if you pick a red blue green mix where you have blue in proportions of around 10 to 20%, the productivity in terms of your output, whether you have green or red mixed with that, is going to be very similar. So really we're just looking at targeting 10 to 20%, excuse me, blue. Next thing we look at is the stem length, and it can be seen that from the graph that the cool blue color produced the shortest stem length, and we've set that at 100%. Very interestingly, the pure blue actually generated longer stem length, so you know it does demonstrate again that you're better off to mix your spectrum whichever characteristic you're going for. So after that you've got a range of difference in terms of the stem length from the optimum, but you can see again that you are within 10% of that optimum by choosing either the red blue or the mid color temperature, so around 3,000 to 4,000 K color temperature. You will get very close to the optimum in terms of stem length. Combining the two characteristics together then, which was yield and stem length, you are best to go for a mixed spectrum between 10 and 20% blue, and it doesn't particularly matter whether you mix that blue with red or with a mixture of red or green. They're going to be very similarly efficient. From the study then we can see that in terms of photosynthetic efficiency, you've quite a wide choice in terms of picking grow light spectrum. The next but most important aspect is looking at the system that you choose. So we have taken the measurements from lots of different grow light testing and also data sheets from manufacturers' websites, and we have drawn up a table, and this table is in system efficiency, which is the amount of power output, the amount of useful light output for plants, divided by the power consumed. This is shown to you in units of PPFD per watt. Starting off with LED red blue grow lights, they have a range of about 0.9 PPFD per watt up to about 1.5. That is the highest system efficiency that we've tested, and the highest that we can find online from any of the manufacturers' data sheets or specifications. Looking next at HID, on the left hand side in the middle of the spectrum range, you would have HPS and ceramic metal halide. Those systems have peaked now really with an optimized setup at about 1.4 micromoles per watt, and could be as low as 1 micromole per watt in a low end setup. When you go in to use the blue dominant bulbs, such as metal halide, that system efficiency drops to a maximum of 1.3 or so. The most efficient technology widely available today is the Cobb technology, where people are using phosphor-coated LEDs to produce a full spectrum white light. And the system efficiency of using the high efficiency drivers, the Cobb LEDs and glass lenses, enables you to get a very high efficiency of delivery of light to your grow of about 2 micromoles per watt. So when choosing your grow light, two aspects to consider in terms of the efficiency of the system. First is photosynthetic efficiency, and second is your system electrical efficiency. Hopefully we've shown you some information here that will help you to make the right choice for yourself, for your grow. And if you have any issues, please let us know in the comments below. Please check out the blog for this video on the website also, and look forward to your comments. Goodbye and take care.